91 is here, so we probably can't go around back because we get arrested, but I remember watching the Gulf War there, the black, white, and green imagery. And the whole imagery of that song is I'm on the floor, the Gulf War is on, the explosions, Scud missiles, black, white, and green. My mom moving around, my mother's dancing around like there ain't no rip in the seam. While she waltzes with ghosts, I can see what went wrong. She's here, but she's not. Just like her, I'm not home. And this idea of being in your childhood home, there's a war going on. There's a war going on in the house, and you're like, we're here, but we're not here.
This one started here, and it's why it's the beginning of the album, because the whole idea is the album goes from 91 in New York City, Chinatown, driving over the bridge, and then the rest of the album in New Jersey. That's sort of like the literal sonic idea, but then also the concept of going home to find a future. And just like kind of a lot of songs I write, I was playing guitar and I had, you know, a couple like lines, like I was like, I'm here but I'm not, kept going through my head, I'm here but I'm not. So I had these lines, I had these ideas, and then what really brought it together, a woman named Zadie Smith, who's an incredible person, one of my favorite writers, I'd never worked with someone who wasn't in music. And I was kind of telling her about this, and she just, you know, I wish I saved the paper, because she just kind of started helping me frame it and put it together. And that's when it started to come together. It's 91, a war is on, I'm watching black, white, and green. My mother dances around like there ain't no rip in the seam. And every tendency, I wanted to go, and while she's waltzing with ghosts. But it's too sentimental. Like, if you just keep going. And this is early, early, early moments of the song that made me realize that there needed to be a hypnotic texture to it. So I was like, if I just keep this going. I'm here, but I'm not, just like her, I'm not home. Just like her, I'm not home. Just like her, I'm not home. Storefronts change, a new war is on, so rip floorboards from our place. Black out all our windows, and then I kick them from their frames. Wanted to go. Now you could dance with anyone, tattoo yourself a fucking sleeve. You're here, but you're not, and just like you, I can't leave. Just like you, I can't leave. And it's very much like a folk song or a poem. You know, I play it like that. And then I kind of do different versions, a more like jangly one. Storefronts change and new war's on. Saw rip floorboards from our place. Black out all our windows and then I kick them from their frames. Yeah, you could dance with anyone. Tattoo yourself a fucking sleeve. But it just didn't feel right. Tried it on the piano, felt even less right. Felt like there was such like a hyper sincerity in the lyric that something slightly off or melted needed to happen in the music. And I did realize, you know, where I'll give myself some sonic relief or some chordal relief in the just like you, I can't leave. I'm here, but I've been gone just a little too. I said I would do something interesting in the bridge. Enter Annie Clark, who says, well, what if there was just a cello? And the main cello is actually a cello sample from a song called Who I Want You to Love, which was the first, it was on the first Bleachers album, Strange Desires, all these cellos. And I just took one little hit of the cello, looped it. This never stops the entire song. And I'm like, okay. It's a little more hypnotic, but still I'm kind of like, I don't know about the guitar, then I did piano. And then Annie's like, well, what if it's just strings? I happen to be in a studio in California, and Nick Cave and Warren Ellis are next door. We start hanging out, playing some records. They were making Ghost Scene at the time, played us that, it was beautiful. And then Warren came into my studio room and I was playing him this, and I sort of had this vocal and this, you know, it was just.
Is around like there ain't no rip in the seam. While she waltzes with ghosts.
So you've broken it down to like just the story. In the sense of who Zadie is, I made it almost very literary with Annie's help. And then Warren's like, well, let me, brings his violin in, and he starts doing things like this. And he was just
give me another one, playing and plucking at it and shouting and being Warren Ellis. And I just used all of them.
There's so much life in it. You put that together with this. So we're locked. And this is so rigid, but Warren is so loose. Now here comes Warren. All of a sudden you have the consistency of the story with the beauty rendering. Warren?
She's here, but she's not just like her. I'm not home.
Brought in a cello player. Just to support. Secretly, there's hints of. That's going on in the background, which is a foreshadow to the end of when you get the. And also at the end, you get the original electrics back. But all that stuff is happening in this arrangement. And so the makeup of it is this cello sample, Warren Ellis just dancing all over the track, these long cellos playing straight through, me sort of telling it like a story. Patrick Berger played this one synth, which just makes the song a little bit more like a dream, because I thought it got a little serious. Then Patrick goes like this. So this is now Patrick on the dream synth, the cello sample, Warren. And now these are the other string players. Bum, 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 bum. Start getting,
we've been gone just a little too long now.
The bridge is cool because Zadie starts singing in the background. That's kind of another one that, I don't know, it's not in the lyric book, and I don't know if you actually hear it, but Zadie and I wrote this other lyric that was, the bridge ended up being nothing, because you needed space, because it was like story. It was too much information, you needed a breath. And it's the only time you lose the cello, so.
I'm here, but I've been gone just a little too long.
And then, it's actually interesting, I always thought of that song as New York to New Jersey, but it's really New Jersey to New York back, because it's here, 91, the war is on, and it's kind of moving into the city and taking that leap, tearing that place apart, going through this big breakup and loss, and then coming back to New Jersey. Sorry. I used to live here, so we were just talking about it.
My son has a bedroom.
No way.
Graham, I'm in New Milford.
Hi. You're on Leonard Drive?
I wish we never sold that house.
You really fucked up.
And you're back in. You're hypnotized again, but I hit the wrong input. Before we had that in the bridge, Zadie and I had this idea, which doesn't work, but we had this idea that the bridge would sort of be this like comment on the whole song. We said, well, what if everything that happened is just everything that happened? What if everything that happens is everything that happened? So there's a version of the bridge where Zadie was singing.
What if everything that happened is just everything that happened?
And that was just her kind of messing around, but it's living back there somewhere in the distance. Like I said, it's not in the lyric book, and I don't know if you can hear it, but it means a lot for me to have her on there kind of singing this lost lyric. There's a lot living behind it. Patrick doing this dreamy synth in the background. There's all these like harmonies happening. Zadie's harmonizing with me. I don't even know what the fuck these are. These sound like Mellotron trails, kind of leading out of the bridge.
I
but they're all things that are nods to different parts of the making of the song, having Zadie's voice on there, or the sessions when we were writing the lyrics together. Having this cello just exist through the whole thing is Annie kind of cracking the code on how it should sound. Patrick's dream synth, which you can't even really pick out, is the tiniest sonic difference that takes it from like a man with a string quartet to actually someone in their room dreaming about a string quartet. It's a huge difference. The strings, the guitars at the end, which you barely hear, that's like New Jersey to me. So there's all these bits that are kind of all living in the distance, but it's also the sentiment of the song. The song is a story. I'm telling the story about why I'm not fully present, but why I'm trying to have such a big life at the same time. Why I'm fucked up, but why I also still think it's worth grabbing at a future. And that's also one of the biggest lyrics I've ever written. When New Walks Along steals away your aura, flickers a light, and you're sure you've been here before. Like it's a dream, like you're sure you are like capable of having something. I know what I'm not, but just like you, I can't leave. Simple lyric, but to me it's like, you know, isn't that kind of something? Like I know all these areas where I'm lacking or I'm broken, but I can't not try. Album starts with 91, it's this like, all these like kind of horrible stories of why you're broken, leading into some unfounded hope, shouting, we've been gone just a little too long now. I know what I'm not, you know, but I want more. I'm here, but I'm not, but I want more. Album ends with this idea of, I don't have God, but I'm spilling over with faith. What do I do with all this faith? And they're both orchestral moments in different ways. 91 is more hypnotic. What do I do with all this faith is more ethereal. But this touches it. These things kind of bookend it, these sounds. And if you just take out the, without that, such a different song. It's such a different song.
It's like you, all I can't leave, and I'm here, but I'm not. Just like you, I can't leave.
And the second you put it back,
just like you,
fucking grounds it in this heavy, heavy way. It's not a dream. But it's crazy, little choices like that. Like one cello note that just goes over and over is the difference between the song feeling like a dream or the song feeling like you're talking directly to someone. Annie really just cracked that wide open. I might still be toiling with this one, hunched over a piano or a Mellotron, trying to make sense of these lyrics that I love. Wouldn't have occurred to me. That's mostly what I have to say about that.